In this Adobe Firefly tutorial, we'll be creating some text effects using text prompt and the settings. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Hey everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here then please subscribe to my channel which will keep me motivated in creating more helpful videos for you. You can also support me on Patreon. I'll put the links in the description. Alright, let's open the Firefly website. In the previous parts, we talked in detail about the text to image and generative fill. If you haven't watched the previous parts, then you can find the links in the description. In this video, we'll talk about the text effects. You can see some sample text effects here and get some inspiration. Or you can click on any effect and type your own text in this particular style. This tool is very helpful if you want to create amazing looking titles for your poster, brand, or any other project. Alright, let's create our own text effect. Now you have the two sides of the prompt. Here you can type your text on which you want to apply the effects. And here you can type the description of the effect that you want to generate. Let's try burger. And if I leave the text input, then it's gonna use the word Firefly by default. I'll change this text to tasty. It's giving me four options to choose from. And I can regenerate if I want. But let's try a bit more descriptive prompt this time. Burger with pizza and fries. It's giving some better results. If you hover your mouse over any image, you have some options here which are the same that we discussed in the part 1 of the course. You have the option to give feedback to Firefly. And you can download the image from here. Now on the right sidebar, we have some other settings. At the top, we have sample prompts. And these are some pre-made styles that you can use. You can view them all. You can select from nature, material and texture, food and drinks. Let's try this flowers effect. I'll change this text to hope. Let's try it out. And this looks beautiful, isn't it? By the way, you can type up to 20 letters for the text at the moment. So if you have a bigger sentence than that, what you can do is create small pieces of that text and then merge them together in Photoshop or any other software. Alright, next you have the match shape, which is similar to the generative fill's match shape that we discussed in the previous part. Currently it's set to medium. That's why some elements are staying outside the shape of the text. If I set it to tight, then it's gonna try its best to hold the effects inside the shape of the font. And if I set it to loose, then it's gonna allow some elements of the effect to go beyond the shape of the font a bit more. Now which one you should choose totally depends on your prompt and what you want to generate. I'll change it to medium. Next you have the fonts. You can try and choose your required font. But I'll go with the same as before for this tutorial. Next you have the color tab. I'll change the background color to white. Hit refresh. And it'll quickly change the background color. Now the text color can be a little confusing. To explain that, let me change the text. Let's try broken glass. Now if I change the text color to orange from here, and I can't see any difference. Now I've tried it many times, but this setting doesn't seem to be providing any different results. Adobe might be working on this setting at the moment. By the time you're watching this video, this might have already been fixed. But at this moment, if you really want to change the color, then you can mention that in the text prompt. So I'll put that here in the prompt. Let's try it out. And there we go. It has applied the orange color to the text effects. And you can use this technique to change the color of any effect. For example, if I select this flowers effect, the text prompt will be updated. I'll change this text to love. You can see the updated text effect. Now I'll change the pink flowers to white flowers and green leaves to blue. I'll change the match shape to tight because I don't want these extra elements to be strangely scattered. Now it's giving me very neat and beautiful looking titles, perfect for using on a poster, social media or any advertisement. I really like the composition of this one and how these flowers are fitting in the shape of the letter. It has done a great job. Alright, let's create one more effect before we wrap it up. I'll change this text. And here I'll type feathers with eggs in a basket. Let's try it out. So this is a very powerful tool and so easy to use. You just need to be a little bit descriptive and precise in the prompt, and it'll give you amazing results. Finally, if you want to download these images with a transparent background, then make sure to change the background color to this checkerboard. And then download your required images. So that's the end of this video. In the next part, we'll talk about generative recolor. You can find all the links in the description. If you enjoyed this video, then please like and subscribe to my channel so I can keep on making more videos for you and provide you more solutions. If you have any questions or feedback for me, let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.